Definitely something wrong with me, and I knew it. It just didn't make any sense that, like, a healthy 30-year-old woman would have this much back pain and that severe that it would wake me up in the middle of the night.
For 6 months, Lana MacKenna took Panadol every few hours so she could try and get through her day pain-free. It never worked.
I just knew I wasn't being taken, like, seriously by the GP. A lot of my other specialists wrote to him and said, take her for a scan, and he wouldn't listen.
Lana fell into a deep depression. She booked for an appointment with a different doctor so she could be put on a mental health plan.
And I was like, sounds great, let's do it. I was just really relieved that somebody was finally listening to me and taking me seriously.
Lana's gut feeling was right. Something was wrong. Her lungs were filled with fluid, meaning her body was being deprived of oxygen. The first time this happened, doctors didn't notice any signs of cancer. But the second time, the news was much more sinister.
And that's when she said, you've got stage 4 lung cancer. And, yeah, I can't really remember a lot after that because I just kind of shut down emotionally.
In August last year, Lana's lung cancer spread to her brain, causing her seizures and memory loss. Her doctors thought she only had 3 months left to live.
You want all of your children to meet the love of their life and also have a long, happy life with said person. And knowing that that isn't going to happen and how you're going to manage that. And you're angry for a really long time.
Surrounded by her loved ones, Lana rushed to the altar to marry her now husband, Mitch.
Honey, you should know that I could never go without.
It's been 7 months since Lana was given her grim prognosis. Her doctors have since been able to treat most of her 20-odd cancer spots through radiation and immunotherapy.
Lab, obviously, like, defied the odds. I'm not going to get told I'm in remission, whereas a lot of people do with other types of cancers. Stable's the best I can hope for, and that's where I'm at right now.
Lana strongly believes that a screening program for lung cancer is vital.
That's when it'll start changing people's lives earlier so they don't get diagnosed later like I have.
13,000 people are diagnosed with lung cancer in Australia every year.
This is a disease that is Australia's leading cause of cancer death, but tragically is not seen as sexy. It doesn't get things like a pink test. It doesn't get investment in lung cancer nurses. And that's the cruelty of a lung cancer diagnosis.
The Lung Foundation says if a screening program was available, there would be less chance of misdiagnosis because it would be easier for GPs to scan for symptoms.
So if you think about the screening programs for breast cancer and bowel cancer, those have increased survivability for patients into the 90%. After 5 years, only 20% of lung cancer patients are alive. And that's incredibly tragic for our communities.
And for the record, lung cancer isn't just a smoker's disease.
By the time I got the diagnosis, I wasn't smoking at all. But I did ask my oncologist, you know, did I get this because, you know, I have a history of smoking? And she said, there's no way you could have smoked enough to get what you have.
Mark Brooks says he's met lung cancer patients in their early 20s who've never smoked.
The real tragedy for lung cancer, it's often maligned because of its association with smoking, but there are 23 other cancers that have an association with smoking. It's just the lung cancer gets caught out.
Lana doesn't know what her future looks like, but she says confronting death has changed her perspective on life.
I do know that I'm going to die. I do know that it is coming. It's terrifying. You go through the cycle of grief multiple times and it can be triggered over nothing, but that's just what it is. We're all going to die. And for me, it's just about how you view it and how you want to live.
What a wonderful outlook. The Lung Cancer Foundation says here they reckon 12,000 lives could be saved over the next 10 years with that screening program.
Yeah, and if you catch it early, like so many other cancers.
Beautiful souls and their families not having to go through something like that through a screening program.
Yeah. And it's not rocket science. We actually can do that.
No, absolutely.
And it's so important. So important.